When you call 911, you expect to get police and fire response right away. But a patchwork of outdated radio equipment and aging facilities could affect your safety and the safety of the first responders who protect you. Reporter Megan Hutton has more.
Fire medical aid, the town or city you're calling about, please.
Inside Tacoma's 911 dispatch center.
Ording, Washington?
It's evident just how important the communication system is for police and fire officials. Government leaders and first responders are asking voters to consider a new tax on the November ballot. This would create South Sound 911 and bring Pierce County Police and Fire agencies under one umbrella.
You can see it came in as a Tacoma address, but she was actually calling for an address in Ording. So now he's going to transfer that call to the other fire dispatch center that's out in the UP area or Lakewood.
The tax will pay for upgrading the communication system and building two new dispatch centers. Currently, 911 staff work in facilities with outdated technology and structural problems.
We currently have six different call receiving and dispatch centers in the county. The model that's been suggested is that we go to two. Two are easier to maintain than six.
One of our most concerning things would be an earthquake. Our dispatch center is not built to withstand that. And so anybody who would need emergency service after that may not be able to get them because our dispatch center may literally fall down.
Pierce County buys their equipment, Tacoma buys theirs, Lakewood buys theirs, but why not have a system where we're maximizing on being able to buy equipment for a larger pool of people and actually saving money in the process.
One of the most important needs is upgrading police and fire from analog to digital radios. Right now, first responders often cannot talk to each other during an emergency outside of their own agency.
I was unable to get on my microphone and say to the fire units, it's back here, and vector them in. I had to talk to my dispatch had to call their dispatch center had to talk to them. If they had any questions, they needed to talk to their dispatch center, which would call my dispatch center, which would talk to me.
Here in Tacoma, we have a lot of high-rise buildings, we have buildings with basements, and so you've got to have a strong enough radio system to penetrate through a bunch of concrete and steel, frankly, to get the communication devices to work, and so there are some places where we have problems with that.
The ballot measure calls for a sales tax increase of 0.1%. That's a penny on a $10 purchase. It creates a funding stream for upgrading 911 services, in addition to what agencies pay in.
The 0.1% will help to pay for the building of those two facilities, and will also help to pay for the operations.
And now for more on the council's action this week, here's Bill Altman.
Voters will get the ultimate decision on upgrading 911 services after the Pierce County Council voted 5-2 this week. Their vote sends the South Sound 911 tax proposal to the November ballot.
That is a seamless, interoperable system that they can count on 24/7 every second of the day and night to make sure what they need an EMT for a loved one, or they need a police officer, or they need a fire truck, they're going to get it faster because of this system in place and the funding is in place.
The sales tax increase would cost county residents 1 cent on a $10 purchase. If approved, it guarantees direct communication between 911 dispatchers, first responders, and the 911 caller.
When they put out a call for backup, that they know that backup is going to be coming. And sadly enough for our county, we have learned the hard way that when an officer puts out a call for help because of those dead zones that are in the county, especially on the east and the west side of the county, those officers cannot always count on that backup coming.
The tax would also pay for improving 911 equipment. That's something that the Federal Communications Commission is mandating in 2013 and again in 2016.
We have a mandate that we have to meet by 2013. We also know that there's another mandate out there for 2016. The prudent thing to do, and I think the best thing to do as stewards of the public's money, is to plan for that as well, to make sure that we don't have to spend money twice.
South Sound 911 combines the agencies of Pierce County, Tacoma, West Pierce Fire, and Lakewood, and the communities that contract with them. They represent 83% of police officers and 99% of firefighters in the county. Some agencies in the central and eastern part of the county are undecided on the proposal.
We do appreciate the vision. We understand the vision. There is no one out there that does not want to improve our 911 communication system. But as a representative of those places in East Pierce County that are not yet on board, I have to vote no today.
One of their major concerns is they've already put in millions of dollars for their systems, and now they feel like, hey, we just paid all this money, and now that's going to be all obsolete. If we waited for a few more years, they would get their time out of the facilities that they've created.
The homes and the property of our people are at stake. Are we at a crisis? Yes, I think we are at a crisis. I think we're at a point where you either go this way or that way, and it has tremendous ramifications for the safety and the quality of life for our people.
If approved, the tax would generate $11.8 million a year over 25 years. Bill Altman, Pierce County News.